Today we will be doing some simple problems on arrays, just on arrays. And is everyone here familiar with arrays or vectors, any such one linear data structure? Okay, cool. I believe all of you would have come across it at least once. So today we are not going to learn an algorithm or data structure again. Rather, we are going to learn certain techniques, okay? Certain techniques which are really, really helpful in solving problems based on arrays, okay? So let us start with maybe one such problem. But before that, let me just tell you, if let's say you were to declare an array like this, okay? Here this n is the size of array. So what are the important qualities of an array? How is it different from any other data structure? So an important attribute is that this is a homogeneous data structure. By that I mean that it will be containing the elements of a particular type. So if this is an integer array, let's say the size of n for example is 5, then it can have 5 integers only, okay? It is not possible that it has few integers and few floats. This is not possible, okay? So that is first important attribute. Second important attribute is that the size is fixed, okay? Size is fixed. So you have to predefine the size, okay? It will never ever so happen that you declared an array of size 5 and you inserted 5 elements and now you are trying to insert 6th element and that will get inserted. No, that won't happen, because whatever initial size you define, the array will just have that much of size, okay? So this is a static data structure, okay? In terms of size, this is static size, okay? Another important thing is that the memory allocation happens in a contiguous manner. So if let's say you have been allotted 5 cells, then all these memory will be contiguous. If let's say this is memory location 1000 and let's say every integer is of 4 bytes, okay, then the next memory will be 1004, then 1008, and so on and on and on, okay? So contiguous memory allocation. These are the 3 most important attributes of an array, okay? The way you have array, this array is a static array, you also have certain dynamic arrays. Can somebody give me an example of a dynamic array that you maybe use in C++ or Java? Yeah, vectors. So does everyone know about, those of you who use Java, you would be using array list. Array list, when you declare an array list or when you declare a vector in C++, do you have to for sure define the size of it? You do not have to do that, right? Because the size grows as and when needed. Okay, another thing, all of you might be aware of function, right? So let's say there is a function and to this function you wish to pass an array. So how do you pass an array? Or let's generalize it, how do you pass a variable? Any variable can be passed by 2 ways. Either pass by reference or pass by value. Is everyone clear with the difference between these 2 things? What is difference between pass by reference and pass by value? Yeah. So passing by reference means passing the address of it. So most of the times it so happens that if you have an array or a vector or a big map or anything, and if let's say you have to pass it from one function to another, then you wish to pass it by address. Okay, which is passing by reference. So how do you pass an array by reference? A very simple way to pass it by reference is that you can have something like this over here. Okay, so this basically assumes that the array that you are trying to pass here is basically passed by reference, and also the size variable over here. So if let's say there is a main function over here, then you can invoke this function func, pass in the array. What is the name of the array? What is the physical significance of the name of the array? The second thing is size though. The physical significance of the name of the array is the base address, okay, base address, which is the address of the first element, okay. So this is just like an address, okay, and this can also be thought of as address of arr of 0, okay. So both of them are exactly the same things, okay, and since these are addresses, addresses are stored in pointer, so this is like a pointer only, nothing much more different than that. You can also prefer to receive it in something like this, okay. And then when you do p of I, or if let's say array of I, whatsoever it is, then you will basically be accessing the ith element of your array, okay. So this is how pass by reference works. Now when you pass an array by address or by reference, then it's very, very obvious that just the address is getting passed, okay. It's nothing like that a new array would be getting created or something like that. That would not happen. So pass by reference is much quick also, because you just pass the address. You do not try to create a new array or a new vector in the new function, okay. What is the default pass of array? You mean what is the default way to first of all, it depends from languages to languages. So this way, if you pass in C or C++, by default it is in this way. If you do it this one, this is pass by reference, okay. So let us start. So you have been given an array containing n integers, okay, and you have been given three more integers, let's say p, q and r, okay. So you have been given array of integers and you have been given three more integers p, q and r. Now what you have to do is you have to maximize the value of following expression. The expression is p into array I plus q into array j plus r into array k, okay, where array I, array j and array k are the elements of my array and their indices obey this property that I is smaller than j and j is smaller than k. So under these constraints I have to maximize the value of this expression. So let us take a quick example. Let's say my array contains these elements 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and let's say my p, q, r are following, p, q and r are 1, 2 and 3. What will be the answer for this case? Yeah, 26, right? So 26 you are getting. Which elements have you chosen? Have you chosen this, this and this? Is this what you have chosen? Yeah, so this is what I believe you would have done, because if you multiply 1 with 3 you will get 3, if you multiply 2 with 4 you will get 8, and if you multiply 3 with 5 you will get 15, and this will be 15 plus 8 23 plus 3 26, okay. So if you try to choose any other combination, any other triplet ai aj ak, then you will end up getting a value smaller than 26 only, okay. So this is the maximum possible value of this expression. So an important thing to be kept in mind is this also, that their indices should be also sorted. I mean, you cannot choose this one as a of 5 and this one as a of 4 and this one as a of 7, okay, because 5, 4 and 7 do not obey this thing, okay. So you have to keep in mind this thing also, and then you have to maximize this particular expression. So any thoughts? What are the approaches that strike your mind immediately? Three nested loops. Can I simply get it done through three nested loops? I can do it, right? So I can consider all the triplets, okay, I can consider all the triplets in my array ai aj ak, okay, consider all such triplets And for all such triplets, you calculate the value of E into AI plus Q into AJ plus R into AK. Okay? And whatever would be the maximum of these, that would be your answer. But one thing that you have to be careful about while implementing is that I, J and K must follow this pattern. So you have to write your code for this brute force approach also in a manner that this particular constraint is getting obeyed. So how do you do that? Let's say you start with I from 0 till n and you are doing I plus plus. Okay. Now inside this, you would want to write another loop to start considering j. Okay. So from where should you start your j? Should you start it from 0 or should you start it from I plus 1? Where? You should start it from I plus 1, because if you start it from 0, then you would end up considering I equals to, let's say, 5 and j equals to 0, which is not allowed. So your j should go from I plus 1, j lesser than n, and j plus plus. And now within this, how about your k? So your k, as you might have guessed, will start from j plus 1, k lesser than n, k plus plus. Now when you are here, then you have a particular ak, aj and ai, and you can calculate this expression and you have a default answer, which is initially minus infinity. Okay.